can see George, he has to unhinge his jaw, basically, to get the mouse in. So his mouth gets significantly bigger. The snake's jaws have two hinges, unlike people's or other mammals that have only one. He uses all the muscles in his neck to pull that mouse in and stretch it. The rule of thumb is that you don't give him a mouse that's larger than the thickest part of his body, even though it's larger than his head, width-wise. So once it gets down to his stomach, it'll be okay. It'll be a little bit of a bulge.
You want to move that plastic bag? It's giving a shine, yeah.
Now the interesting part is he actually has to squeeze, when he gets this mouse down his throat, it squeezes past his internal organs that are near the top of his, front of his body, so it squeezes past his heart, his lungs, everything to get to his stomach, which is further down. So he has to be very stretchy and, you know, literally have to have a moment when his heart is being pushed to the side by the mouse. As you can see, he uses his neck muscles to pull it in and push it down through his body. And now that he's eaten, he'll be good for about a week. Won't need to eat at all. That neck movement is both the most painful thing and most satisfying thing I've ever seen. And there you have it.